Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Laura and I host a podcast that comes out on a weekly basis on this channel called The Suitcase Coder, the podcast. Super original, I know. If this is not your first time back, then you've noticed that I'm no longer in a game closet. I'm actually in a very nice backyard of this awesome Airbnb, which is being rented out by my sister and her family who are out of town. So I'm actually pet sitting. Shiner, come on. Okay, he's not interested. Anyway, today I'll be going over some of the reasons why I think it's important to have a mentor as you're learning to code. I had a mentor thanks to the boot camp that I attended. It was actually one of the main reasons that I decided to go with this boot camp versus another boot camp. I understand that many of you might not have that opportunity to have a mentor right off the bat. So some common ways to find a mentor would be both the easiest and maybe the hardest way is get yourself out there and start networking, whether it's online, which I know most things are. As the world does open up a little, start finding local communities that are also getting involved in tech, whether they're learning the exact same stack as you are or not. And something that I've found is that if you do have people who are a little bit more advanced, more senior level developers that are showing up for entry level developers, then that kind of goes to show that they already have it in their mind that they want to be involved and help other people who are going through something that they probably went through themselves. And they're probably a little bit more open to helping you out. The other way, of course, would be if you do know any software developers, whether that's in your current career, who would be willing to teach you or even like be willing to give out a hand. And another thing to keep in mind is don't expect this to be free, just like we want all of our freelancers and everybody to be able to get paid for the work that they do. You might find somebody who would be willing to volunteer their time, but if you do want like a strong mentor, I think it's almost as important to pay them because it can help with some of the things that we'll talk about today. And I will try to do some homework myself and see if there are any existing resources that could help you find a mentor, either online or in person. So I'll put any of those in the show notes or in the description below. All right, so once you do find yourself a mentor, there are a couple things that they could definitely help you out with. And some of them we'll be going over a little bit more in depth, but definitely accountability, sharing their expertise, doing life practices with them, and a few others. So back to accountability, one of the main things, and here comes the part with money that I was saying, one of the things that they could really, really help you out with is having a dedicated time, whether that's weekly or monthly, to sit down with you and either go over live coding challenges with them in person or going over maybe some curriculum that you have. But the thing is, if you have paid them for their time, that is not something that neither you nor they will want to miss. And it's something that they will put in as much effort as you are wanting them to put in. Another thing with the accountability is if you are meeting with them once a week, let's say, then you're gonna wanna show up a little bit prepared. You're not gonna just wanna wait for that 1 hour a week to actually code with them. You're gonna want to practice and do things on your own and try other things by yourself and save any of those like questions that you get when you're stuck to meet with your mentor. So not only is it accountable during those scheduled times, but also it's gonna motivate you to put in a little bit of work before the actual meetings. And at least from what I found, like the more work you put into it, the more you have to show off, you will start to be proud of the work that you've done between the times that you meet with your mentor. And this is definitely a way to help keep you on track as long as you share your goals and your progress with your mentor so that they have a timeline of what you're getting accomplished as well as making sure that you are reaching those goals. So just having that schedule, not only for yourself, but with somebody else is obviously like an immediate kind of accountability that you can find with a mentor will actually care about you making a progression in your coding journey. Another really important thing is to share your why with the mentor. Having somebody to share the reason why you're doing the thing too is super important because let's say you spend a whole session just being frustrated, which is totally fine. Like that's another thing you could do with your mentor is just kind of let out those frustrations that come about when you are learning to code. And if you share your why with them, then they can remind you of that why in times when you are struggling to code. Besides maybe some of those more obvious reasons why you might need a mentor is guidance. And I mean like technical guidance. So let's say you want to learn how to code on your own, but you don't know where to start. You don't know which languages to learn. You don't know which resources to look up. This is where your mentor can really help you out and help. Even if you are doing a bootcamp, they can help guide you through the curriculum or guide you through or help create your own curriculum so that you can learn to code on your own and follow a certain path and a path that will be helpful to you in the long run. They can also definitely help you figure out what kind of projects would be good for you to learn and also at which pace you should be learning each of these things. Let's say you're spending way too much time on HTML, they can kind of tell you, okay, you've got the basics, now let's move on to the next thing. And HTML would just kind of come as you continue learning. So having a mentor can definitely help with like the track of your journey and helping you not have to think about like, what do I have to learn next? That way you can just get on track and do the things that you're supposed to do rather than spending too much time trying to figure out what to do next. Another thing that I talked about at the very beginning is having a piece of their expertise. So no, there's still no way to like just transfer knowledge from brain to brain without doing any work, unfortunately. But one thing that you could definitely have from a mentor is having somebody with that knowledge accessible to you right then and there. With this knowledge comes a bunch of resources that they have used either when they were starting off or in their day-to-day life. They have knowledge in what it's like to be a developer in the actual work environment. They have knowledge as to what projects will be actually helpful to you versus not. And of course, they just have the years of experience and knowledge in how to apply what you're learning to like an actual thing. When you're feeling stuck or when you're starting off on a project, it's good to have a totally different insight. And sometimes it's nice to have somebody who can see the big picture rather than if you're learning by yourself or even with a bootcamp, you're trying to learn as you build. And that can get really confusing sometimes. But with a mentor, they can help you see the big picture before you start. And of course, having the mentor and the time dedicated to where you can go into the meeting or session, whatever you want to call it, and just have a list of questions and answers and be able to ask any and all questions you want with an expert without having to like spend too much time on Google. So I think that's also just kind of time saving in being able to learn. A few other things that they can help with the more technical aspect is providing technical coaching as far as like practice for technical interviews that you will come across, getting comfortable talking about your code in front of somebody who is more knowledgeable, being able to do coding challenges, and maybe them being able to pull from examples from their real life jobs. You could also practice pair programming with them, which is something that I know is used in a lot of companies. If you do find yourself a mentor, I would definitely take advantage of using them not only to like sit there and wait for them to tell you what to do, but come prepared, come with ideas on what you guys can do together. Make sure you know what you want to get out of the mentorship. I think as long as you know what you want out of your mentor, that should really be able to increase what you get out of these mentorship programs rather than just having somebody like pat you on the back and say, good job, keep going, you know. No matter how long you work with a mentor, usually they're gonna see and want to see some kind of progress, because if you progress and become a better developer with their help, they're gonna be proud of being able to have helped you, and also you're gonna be happy with the work that they've done, and you might recommend their services to somebody else. So it really is like a win-win situation. And at the end of your sessions or towards the end of your sessions, you can also think of it as a greater networking opportunity, because if you think about it, they probably have a way bigger and probably way different network than you currently do. And the great part about that is that because they mentored you, because they saw your growth and pushed for your growth, they're going to be proud of your work and they're going to want to recommend you. And who knows, maybe they might even be hiring in the company that they work for, and they might just bring you onto your own company even beforehand, like as an intern. So think of finding a mentor really as an investment to your learning. And as promised, the absolute best part of having a mentor, at least this should be the case, is that you can show up to these sessions and ask as many questions as you want without the sense of feeling stupid that you might not know as much as you would need to know, because that's what they're there for. They're there to help you out. Just from my experience, like if I were to go back and get my own mentor, these are probably some of the things that I would bring up with them, just so that I look now looking back would get the absolute most out of my mentors. If you do get a mentor and they're not like super helpful, then it's okay to drop them. Like you, like I said, are probably paying for this service, and if you're not getting out of it what you want, then you should definitely drop them. That sounds bad, but like drop them and move on and find something that's going to work for you, because this is your time and your money as well. So yeah, thanks for listening, and I hope you enjoy this episode. If you did enjoy it, please don't forget to rate on Apple Podcasts. Thanks again, and until next time. Ciao.